Hello, friends. My name is Sanjay Singh, and I'm your business performance coach. This series is called Business Muscles. It's dedicated towards small and medium enterprise owners. Jiya dosto, chalak malak company. The owner of a small and medium enterprise is more often than not always battling with time. He is working for the entire day. He doesn't have a Sunday in his life. He doesn't know what does it mean to invest or rather spend an evening with the family. His children are getting older. He doesn't have time to enjoy with them. He doesn't even have time to enjoy the money that he is earning. His life is wretched. And if you ask this SME CEO, that why is it that you're not able to find time? He generally ends up blaming his ecosystem. He says that, Sanjay, I don't have the right subordinates to help me. I don't have the right people around me to assist me. Finally, after paying salaries to so many people, I end up doing all my job myself. I really don't know why I have kept these people, because they're all nincompoops, they're useless, they're absolutely rubbish. I don't know why God has chosen me with all this horrible set of employees. Now, friends, you have to understand that God cannot be so bad that he has chosen you, a hardworking person, to shower all his blessings, no, not blessings, all his wrath on you by giving such employees. You have to understand that an employee will be productive and an employee will be performing only when you have clearly defined productivity and performance for each employee reporting it to you. In management, we call it SOP or standard operating procedure. Ask yourself this question. Have you defined SOP for every possible activity that your juniors are supposed to do? Let me give you an example. There is an accountant who reports into you. Now, when the accountant brings a voucher to you for your approval, does he know what are the 5 things, 6 things, 7 things that he needs to vouch before he gets a voucher to you? Are these 6, 7 things in writing, and has it been tutored to him as part of SOP? If not, you can invest the rest of your life and you'll still not get a person who's worthy enough to support you. So number one, try to build SOPs for all your core employees and ensure that the SOPs are documented. Number two, even after you document the SOP, it is not necessary that your subordinate is so intelligent that just by reading the document, he or she will understand what exactly they are expected to do. So there has to be a culture of training. There has to be a culture of learning and development where on a regular basis, maybe every day initially and then weekly subsequently, you have to empower your subordinates so that they understand the letter and spirit of each statement mentioned in the SOP. So two things. One, define SOPs for every employee of yours, documented SOP, get it validated, ratified by subject matter experts. And two, invest your quality time in empowering your subordinates so that they understand each element of your SOP in letter and spirit. Do these two things and you will very shortly realize that the same nincompoops who were a rat in your life have suddenly become angels to support you. And a good story will end up with you investing quality time with your family, with your children in the evenings, and having quality time to think about yourself and your business in the future and relax with your legs spread out on a Sunday. Think about it.